जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19। A top IED expert and a Pakistani national was among three Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorists killed in an encounter which ensued after security forces launched a cordon and search operation in South Kashmir district of Kulgam on Friday. One of the killed terrorists has been identified as Jaish-e-Mohammed commander Walid Bhai, a Pakistani national and an improvised explosive device expert, and was in the list of top wanted terrorists in the valley. Meanwhile, three soldiers were also injured during the exchange of fire.
एक आसवा मारा गया वलीद भाई जो जेएस का टॉप कमांडर है। कल रात में कुलगांव पुलिस को इंफॉर्मेशन मिला था कि चिम्मर विलेज में तीन टेररिस्ट छिपे हुए हैं।
Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu today flagged off a ready-to-deployment mobile genset fleet for the emergency response and disaster relief and recovery in case of natural disasters and extreme weather events in Kashmir. The 10 gensets would be stationed in each district in preparation for any eventuality and a disaster preparedness measure. The Lieutenant Governor directed the Jal Shakti Department for immediate procurement of 10 more mobile gensets to strengthen the emergency response system in case of any eventuality. Indian Army T-90 tanks and BMP infantry combat vehicles carried out the exercise at Stakna, lay in presence of Defence Minister Rajnath Singh, Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat and Army Chief General M.M. Naravane on Friday. The Defence Minister witnessed para-dropping and scooping weapons here. He also inspected a Pika machine gun. Troops of armed forces carried out para-dropping exercise here in presence of the Defence Minister and Army officials. Defence Minister is on a two-day visit to Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. He will take stock of the situation at both the line of actual control and the line of control. Approving the second relief package to revive Jammu and Kashmir's economy, the Lieutenant Governor administration waived stamp duty on fresh loans, surcharges on fixed charge for power and extended amnesty scheme, filing of GST returns. To tackle the shutdown of economy due to COVID-19 pandemic, the Administrative Council, which met under the chairmanship of Lieutenant Governor G.C. Murmu in a focused policy intervention aimed to address concerns amongst various stakeholders, approved a relief package to revive the economy. Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory on Friday approved Housing Policy 2020 and over 2 lakh houses will be built over the next few years. The Administrative Council, which met here under the chairmanship of Lieutenant Governor G.C. Murmu, accorded sanction to the proposal of Housing and Urban Development Department for adoption and notification of J&K Housing, Affordable Housing, Slum Redevelopment and Rehabilitation and Township Policy 2020. The policy envisages 7 models of housing, ranging from in situ slum redevelopment to integrated township to cater to the need of every section of society. The Administrative Council of Jammu and Kashmir on Friday approved the rollout of excise policy for 2020-21 and implementation of policy measures to improve transparency and objectivity related to renewal, cancellation, transfer of licenses and penalties. The council met here under the chairmanship of Lieutenant Governor G.C. Murmu. The new policy aims to rationalize the number of taxes, duties and other levies to optimize revenues for common good and bring about greater social consciousness about the harmful effects of consumption of liquor and alcoholic beverages. Restrictions were further tightened on Friday in Srinagar, where business and other activities remained crippled since Monday after district administration ordered imposition of fresh lockdown in view of sudden spike in COVID-19 cases. The lockdown was imposed in over 60 containment zones on Monday following a surge in coronavirus cases over the past 1 week. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh on Friday launched the reconstructed Prime Minister's Awards for Excellence in Public Administration 2020 scheme and web portal in which for the very first time, the Good Performance for Ganga Rejuvenation Award has been instituted. This year, for the very first time, the PM's Awards for Excellence in Public Administration seeks to recognize the efforts of district-level officials involved in the Namami Gange program. This is an exemplary recognition for the initiatives being taken up under the Namami Gange mission. Under the award category, one award shall be given to a district out of the 57 notified district Ganga committees under the Namami Gange program. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday said talks are underway to resolve the border dispute between India and China and assured that not one inch of Indian land can be taken by any power in the world. The Defence Minister interacted with the troops in Lungkung along with Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat and Army Chief General M.M. Naravane.
इकलौता देश है जिसने सारे विश्व को शांति का संदेश दिया है। भारत दुनिया का इकलौता देश है जिसने कि दुनिया के किसी देश पर न तो कभी आक्रमण किया है और न दुनिया के किसी देश की एक इंच जमीन पर कभी कब्जा किया।
Alleging brazen disregard for the concerns of the educated unemployed and underemployed youth of J&K by the incumbent government, Harshdev Singh, chairman JKNPP and former minister, regretted that discontent amongst youth was growing with each passing day after the abrogation of Article 370. He said that BJP-led government had announced to create 50,000 posts immediately after reorganization of J&K with absorption of the educated youth against the set post on fast-track basis. It was followed by another announcement in budget session of parliament of 50,000 creations of the new jobs. He, however, regretted that not only were the youth cheated in the name of employment package post Article 370 abrogation, but the existing vacancies were also allowed to remain unfilled. With a record single-day surge of 34,956 cases, India's COVID-19 tally zoomed past 10 lakh on Friday, just 3 days after it crossed the 9 lakh mark. The total coronavirus case load in the country surged to 10,03,832, while death toll mounted to 25,602, with the highest number of 687 fatalities recorded in a day. Around 63.33% of patients have recovered so far. It took 110 days for the COVID-19 cases in the country to reach 1 lakh and just 59 days more to go past the 9 lakh mark. This is the sixth consecutive day when the cases increased by more than 28,000. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi on Friday targeted the central government over the India-China standoff, stating since 2014, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's constant blunders and indiscretions have fundamentally weakened the country. In the video clip, the Congress leader said in the last 6 years, India was disturbed and disrupted because it failed in various areas such as protecting the economy, foreign relations, and added that these situations had made China act in such an aggressive way. Pakistan has offered third consular access to India for its national Kulbhushan Jadhav, Pakistani media reports on Friday said. The reports quoting Pakistan foreign Shah Mahmood Qureshi said a note verbal has been sent meeting India's demand to not have security personnel during the meeting. This comes a day after India has said that its national Kulbhushan Jadhav was visibly under stress, as Pakistan did not permit a free conversation between him and the consular officers and they were not given unimpeded, unhindered and unconditional access. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday arrived in the summer capital to review security situation along the line of control, international border and hinterland in Jammu and Kashmir. Singh, who was accompanied by Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat and Army Chief General M.M. Naravane, reached at Technical Airport in Srinagar on Friday afternoon after visiting forward areas and reviewed security situation along line of actual control in the Union Territory of Ladakh in the morning. The Jammu and Kashmir government has evacuated about 2,30,782 JK residents stranded in other parts of the country due to COVID lockdown by Lakhanpur and through special trains and buses till date amid strict observance of all necessary guidelines and stranded operating procedures. As per the official data received in this regard, The Jammu and Kashmir administration has received 86 special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway stations from different states and UTs so far, with about 71,802 passengers, while about 1,58,980 persons from other states and UTs, including 896 from abroad, have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date.